goodness, there you are. Doctor, wait a minute.
What is it?
Carter and I, we found the vampire. Her name is Elizabeth Renata.
I know.
We found the room where she sleeps, and I need your help to get into it.
You don't need to see her. It's pointless.
I don't know what that creature's told you, Doctor, but she's lying. She just wants to turn you into the same kind of murdering monster she is. Think!
Too late.
No, it's not. Don't let her do this to you. Concentrate!
You know, one of the things that drove me to you, Dara, just how fiery you are.
Oh, blast it! Listen to me!
Fiery, young, so full of life.
Doctor? Doctor?
Not while I'm eating.
Doctor!
Dara, please! The medical section's empty!
I know!
You're my friend! I don't want to hurt you! Please! Get out of my way!
No one's going to get hurt if I can help it! Especially you, Doctor!
It's too late for that.
Doctor, no!
Far too late.
No! Ah! Ah! Doctor! Oh, Doctor, I still believe in you! Please! I know you! You can't do this! Carter, help!
Doctor, what? Dara! Dara, are you all right?
Doctor, please wait! We can help you! Come back! Oh, Carter, I'm so glad to see you!
I'm glad to see you in one piece. Doctor tried to bite you, didn't he?
Yes, but...
we've got to kill him.
What? Are you mad? We can't kill the doctor!
There's no choice. I saw his face on the way out. He's becoming a vampire, too.
It's not his fault. How can you be so heartless?
Don't understand how serious this is. If we delay, it'll be too late.
I understand perfectly well how serious this is, but there are some things you don't understand. For starters, look around you.
What do you mean?
Ooh, get your head out of the fog and look!
I still don't... wait. I came through the door of that box. Where are we now?
We're inside it. It's bigger inside than out. Dimensionally transcendental is what the doctor calls it.
How can that be?
The doctor's not a human being. His people come from another planet. Maybe even another galaxy. They built this. It's a time machine.
A time machine? What are you?
Well, I'm human enough. But I come from nearly 100 years in the future. And there's something else. The doctor explained to me what vampires are.
I already...
No, you don't. Now, listen. A really long time ago, the doctor's people had a war against these creatures called the Great Vampires. They were so big and terrible, they could destroy whole planets. The doctor's people killed them all, but they had servants. This Renata must be one of them.
So you're saying vampires originally came from outer space?
Yes.
All this is useful, but it doesn't change anything. We still have to kill the doctor. If we don't, he'll become a soulless monster, desecrating everything he touches. I let this happen once before. I won't let it happen again.
Is that why this matters so much to you?
The damage has already been done. I have to make up for it somehow.
What happened?
I've been hunting Renata for years. It started out as a lark, something to pass the nights on trains. But then I realized vampires were real, and she was real. Most people never believed me, fortunate for them.
But some did?
Yeah, she killed them, one by one. But never me. Almost like she was taunting me. And then... Frida.
I know you don't want to talk about it, but I think I should know.
She believed in Renata. She believed in me.
And Renata killed her?
I killed her.
You killed her?
Renata's last insult turned her into a vampire, too. I had to kill her. Had to make it look like an accident. Ran for my life.
That's enough. I'm sorry, Carter. It wasn't your fault.
I don't care about that. I just can't let her get away with it again.
I want Renata dead as much as you do. But whatever happened before, you won't make up for it by making a worse mistake now. There has to be another way.
I don't know.
Come on, Carter, think. I know how much you've studied vampires. There has to be something we can do to help the doctor.
Well, there might be one thing. If we kill Renata before she bites the doctor a third time, he might go back to normal. I can't be sure.
But you think it would work?
There's so much information and a lot of conflicts. But I'm pretty sure I've read that in at least two different accounts.
Then we've got to get her before the doctor does. Come on.
The house is dark. Maybe he hasn't gotten here yet. Hold my satchel while I take care of the front door.
What's in here?
Everything we can possibly need to make an end to that monster.
You do mean Renata?
Yes. Door's open now. Let's go.
Oh, I'd hoped I'd never have to come back to this basement.
I know what you mean. I've never been here before, but I've had nightmares about this place for years. What are we going to do about this door? Did you find something to open it?
After a fashion. There. I once heard the doctor say that the more complex the technology, the easier it was for brute force to put a spanner in the works, or something like that.
Nice to know you can pick even locks like that with a hairpin.
Come on.
Good evening, children. I've been waiting for you.
You knew we...
Of course, you little fool. I was counting on it. Now you will both serve me, won't you?
Yes, Lady Renata.
And you, Carter Evans, have been a thorn in my side far too long. I thought after dear Frida you'd give up.
Never! Plague! That stalks in the darkness!
Enough! Be silent, Carter Evans. You will serve me now, won't you?
I will, Lady Renata.
How far do I have to go through this cursed city to find someone who won't run away from me? Whether I actually like these human fools is beyond me.
Can you spare some change?
Yeah.
Can you
on the mission steps.
Change?
He's got nowhere else to go.
Excuse me, can you spare some change?
He'll never be missed.
Can you spare
softly
some change?
Now. Softly.
What? Who's there?
It's just me.
Hey, mister. Could you help a fella down on his luck?
No. But you can serve me.
Now! Get away from me! What do you want from me?
You? Your kind? Your entire miserable planet. None of it would be here but for me. You owe me.
You're a vampire. This is a cross. You can't come past.
Can't I? To you, this is just a place of food and shelter. The symbol means nothing to you. So it means nothing to me.
No! No! Please don't!
Save your breath! You'll need it if I let you live.
Help! Please! Somebody help me!
Help. They all said help. They're all frightened. Just like you. All over time. Space. I was there. What am I doing? Don't! I won't hurt you. I'm sorry. Done. In heaven's name. What have I done? No!
There now. Let's all be a little more comfortable, shall we? Dara, take the chain from around Mr. Evans' neck.
Dara, don't.
I can't help it.
Good. Just drop it on the floor. And that cross you have in your jacket. Get rid of it, too. Very good. Now, both of you, upstairs. We can all wait for the doctor in comfort.
Why don't you just kill me and get it over with?
So soon, Mr. Evans? You surprise me. After all the effort you've gone to, you would give up now? Or is it that you already have? The demon of despair overwhelmed your obsession at last? Now, take some rope out of that satchel of yours and tie Dara to that chair.
Carter, come on, don't cry. Concentrate. You can break her spell if you try.
Sorry. Not strong enough. Not for you. Or Frida. Or any of the others.
You see? He's given up. Come here, Mr. Evans. I'm hungry. And I've been waiting for this particular meal a long time.
Let's fight her!
Too late. Far too late. Now, Dara. No, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm saving you for the doctor.
He won't hurt me.
Once I have bitten him for the last time, he'll do anything I want him to.
But how are you going to get him here? He ran away from me, and he isn't here. Maybe he won't show up at all.
Even now he is coming. Coming because I have called him. To think that I, just a slave to the Ancient Ones, will now have one of the great enemy under my thumb. At last I shall be paid for all my lifetimes of waiting. Doctor, welcome. I have missed you tonight. What took you so long to answer my call?
I suffered a moment of weakness. I needed time to compose myself again.
It is difficult to think of these mortals for what they really are, isn't it? Like this one here.
You mean food?
Carter, you're alive!
Only just. She's still toying with me.
Ignore him, Doctor. I think he envies me. Come, I have your friend waiting. Take some of her blood, and then you will be strong enough to join me forever.
Doctor, I know you don't really want to do this. Think. You've always cared for me, looked out for me. You've looked out for everyone who ever needed your help.
True. I have been a good shepherd, caring for those weaker than I am.
Yes, and we need you now, the real you, the good you.
Can't you see the truth, girl? He's always been a predator, just as I am. Doctor, you know the truth about yourself. You don't have to pretend anymore.
She's right, Dara. It's time for me to take back all that I've given away. Eventually, the shepherd drives his flock to the shearing shed. Or the slaughterhouse.
Doctor, stop! If you do this, you'll be her slave! She's using you, don't you see? It's a trap!
What's this?
It's Carter's, Doctor!
Tools of the trade. Mallet. Wooden stakes. A very nasty-looking knife and... two sticks of dynamite?
Renata was right! You are obsessed, aren't you, Evans? Shall I try some of these out on you?
You can kill me if you like. Kill your friend, too. We'll be dead. Beyond caring. But you will live forever. Accursed. And you'll remember this night.
Ignore that, fool. Take the girl, and quickly. It's already dawn.
Doctor, no! Please!
No!
Ah! Doctor! Let me go! The sunlight will kill me!
Maybe both of us.
Why?
Because Rassilon told us to destroy you! Because you have outlived your usefulness! We're parasite-serving dead monsters! And because you lied to me!
Not all lies. So alone. If you wouldn't stay, I'm glad you... killed me.
Alone. Indeed.
Doctor! Doctor, are you alright?
Yes. I'm alright. I killed her.
She had to die. We all knew that.
Like this? I suddenly saw that you were right. She wasn't being kind to me. Mind me as a slave. And for that, I killed her. Not for necessity. But for hate.
You did what you had to, Doctor. I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Maybe I have, anyway. I'm sorry we weren't able to finish my lessons.
So am I. But I think I'm going to be taking a sabbatical from magic. After she bit me, I could feel Renata's presence. Even though she's dead, I can still feel something.
You think there may be other vampires out there?
Well, if there are, I'll find them. Doctor, she bit you twice. Do you have any lingering effects?
Aside from a craving for steak tartare, no. And I'm sure even that will pass quickly.
And that's all?
That's all. Good luck to you, Mr. Evans.
Goodbye, Carter. Good hunting.
And to you.
Doctor?
Yes, Dara?
When you told Mr. Evans that you didn't have any other effects from the bite, you were lying, weren't you?
Yes. Suppose I was.
Doctor, I have to know. What happened to you?
Come along, Dara. We got places to go and people to see.
Not yet. You can't go on as if this never happened.
had to face down the one thing in the universe I had no idea how to deal with. My own darker self. I spent so long trying to convince myself that my capacity for evil didn't exist anymore. I had myself convinced too. Till now.
We all have the capacity to do right or wrong, Doctor. But you've chosen to do right. That's the important thing.
I suppose it is.
And your choosing to do good has inspired people all across time and space to do the same. Including me, I might add.
Well, I can't let you all down now, can I? Shall we go?
Now, that's the Doctor I know.